In this video, we're going to walk through how to develop your functions in order to make sure you can solve your data needs. We'll remember to use the right syntax, which we learned in the previous video. As these are all examples, anything written in bold, we can just assume is an attribute that's in our AF structure. Before I go through all the solutions, I recommend trying to sit down and developing these yourself. After you've finished writing out the solutions, take a look at the video to compare your answers. There may be multiple ways of doing the same function. We'll talk about the one that I think is the most direct way to get your answer. For this first one, we can see that we want to get a 10-minute rolling average of the temperature attribute. To get a 10-minute rolling average, our hint is to use the tag average function. Let's take a look at the tag average function in the help section of Pi System Explorer. Again, in Pi System Explorer, you can hit the help button and you can navigate down to Asset Analytics, Expression Functions Reference, and then take a look at Tag Average. In the syntax, we can see we need an attribute name, a start time, and an end time, and an optional parameter is a percent good. Writing this out, we can see that we want to get a 10-minute rolling average for the temperature attribute. Our attribute name in that case is going to be temperature. Our start time is going to be 10 minutes ago from now, which would be star, meaning now, minus 10m. And our end time is now, to complete the 10-minute rolling average time period. We can see that we're not asked to specify any percent good, so we'll leave the optional parameter out. Making sure that we envelop our attribute value as well as our timestamps in single quotes, we can see that if we take the tag average, temperature attribute, we can see that the following function will answer our problem. Let's take a look at the next one. Get the time-weighted total for the flow-in attribute over the last hour, but only if at least 80% of the values used in the calculation are considered good. In this case, the function that we'll want to use is the tag_tote function. Again, looking up some of our syntax in the help menu, we can see that we'll need an attribute name, and similar to the tag_average function, the start time and end time. We can also specify a 2-unit and a percent good. In this case, we're going to use the percent good and make sure that we set that at 80. Let's take a look at the solution. Again, making sure that we enclose the attribute value and timestamps in single quotes, and because 80 is just a number, we can leave that without any other syntax. The third problem states, how much time in the percentage of a day was the pressure attribute between 30 and 70, excluding the time when the value is at 30 or 70 for the whole day yesterday? Here we're going to need to combine two different functions. So our hint here shows that the time GT and time GE. Time GT is greater than, and time GE is greater than or equal to. Let's take a look at one of those in the help menu. We can see that we need to specify the attribute name, the start time, and the end time, as well as X. If we look at the definition, it says, find the total time within a range when an attribute value is greater than a specified value. Time returned is in seconds. It's important to note that the time returned is in seconds, and that we need to put in a specified value. In that case, the attribute name we'll know is pressure, the start time and end time we can configure using yesterday and today, and X represents the value that we'd like to specify. We need to combine the greater than and greater than or equal to functions in order to make sure that we exclude the right amount of time. In this case, we're going to take the time that the pressure attribute from yesterday at midnight until today at midnight was greater than 30, and we'll subtract out the portion of time where it was greater than or equal to 70. After that, we'll divide by the amount of seconds in a day, which is 86,400, and to make it a percentage, we'll multiply by 100. This is a good example to show you that you can string together multiple functions in order to get a more sophisticated equation together. For the last problem, we would like to display overload when the level attribute is greater than or equal to 90, normal when it's between 10 and 90, and we'd like to exclude the boundary values, and if it's less than 10 or equal to 10, we'd like it to display empty. In this case, there's a few ways that we can go about it. The way that I find to be most straightforward is using some if-then-else logic. Taking a look at one of these conditional statements, we can see that it'll return the second of two specified values in the if-then-else statement if the conditional expression is false. That's if you look up else in the help menu. In that case, let's walk through the solution. Notice that if I just want to specify the attribute value at the time of now, I can just put in the attribute name. So if level is greater than or equal to 90, then we'd like it to display overload. I'll put else if the level is less than or equal to 10, then I'll specify empty. The middle range, which I haven't specified yet, will now be the only other option, and there I will write normal. Take note that the string values that I'd like to write to the value of the output are in double quotes. It is possible to rearrange this. However, I believe this is the most straightforward way. If we were to try to specify the normal level after overload, we might be including too much in the range. We would need to specify that it is both greater than or equal to 10 and less than or equal to 90, which is more difficult than just putting it in the way that I've outlined in the solution. There are obviously many more functions to explore, and I recommend taking a look at the help menu if you'd like to get insight onto using our many different functions that we have available.